Dhoni has got his own style, which is so much successful for him. I think we can do a research into his style of wicket keeping, and I would like to call it the Mahi way. And there's so many things to learn from that, and there's so many things which other young keepers may not be able to even contemplate. So he's unique in his own ways, and that is exactly how cricketers should be, unique in their own way. He's got great hands. I mean, he's definitely the best gloveman as far as wicket keeping for spinners goes to. His hands work at the speed of lightning for the stumping, we all know that. So that is something which is very innate to him, which is unique to him, great to watch. At the same time, something which has, for somebody who doesn't have that skill, a big challenge to get there. So he's very unique, and that is the way it should be. He's unbelievable. The Mahi way, that's what I call it. Yeah, PE is called the Windy City, isn't it? If not mistaken, I read that on Wiki. So yeah, definitely we'll take that into consideration. That is something which is important, especially for high balls, and you have to keep that into account. It comes under your awareness. So wherever, no matter where you're fielding on the boundary line, you need to be aware which way the wind is blowing, and you also need to be aware of the batter's tendencies, the game situation, and accordingly you should be able to prepare, you know, in terms of wanting the ball to come to you. Yes, we were little below par on the field in the last game. One catch, Shreyas Iyer being a brilliant fielder that he is. The great attempt, it was not a grade one catch. It's easy to be harsh on ourselves sometimes, okay? Easy to be harsh on our players. It's very easy, the easiest thing to do. But if you see, that was a difficult catch. And the ball, you see the ground in Johannesburg, ball snakes a lot. And it's what happened to Kuldeep. He was trying to attack and save the two. The ball just snaked a little bit more than he expected. So these things happen, but we are practicing for those things. We got our players to get attention to the detail in every minute aspect of every skill, not only fielding. Look, if you really see about the, if I'm talking about the one-day side, definitely there is more athleticism to be seen on the ground. It's on view. And if you see even the last 3-4 series, take right from Champions Trophy to Sri Lanka, Australia, West Indies, the athleticism on the ground has been good. We've been saving more runs than we've been giving away. We've been seeing a lot of runs than the opposition. It was there for everybody to see, even in the Australian series. And other important aspect for positive from this team is, more often than not, the team, the difference between the good days and the bad days is very less. We not flash one day and really bad the other day like few of the other teams. We try and reduce the gap between our good days and the bad days. There is a level to which we can be, and we try and maintain that, try and be consistent on that. That is what is the endeavor. And yes, we work on the technical aspect of fielding as much as we can. But like Ravi and Virat want, we want the 11 best fielders to take the park every time we get out there. That is the endeavor going in for the next 15 months. But definitely we are one of the better one-day fielding teams in the world. I can vouch for that. Well, we are really upbeat about it. We have the confidence of taking the wins in the first three games. We know our game plans. You see, when the games get reduced, when the overs are reduced, then definitely the skill levels between two teams are also reduced, because when there is nothing to lose from a batting side point of view in terms of the situation we had last game after the delays. So that's something which is good. It's happening at this stage for our build-up into the World Cup. Games where you get delayed when you're on a roll, especially when you're batting. So we were 200 for one or 200 for two, 34th over. There was a big delay, broke the momentum. These are the things that we want to happen more in terms of our preparation. We love to embrace such situations so that we, even if we make a mistake, we know how to respond to that same situation the next time around. So these things are good for us, bowling with a wet ball, maybe a wet outfield, reduced games. These are fantastic to happen, and we will learn by every game. And going, as far as your question is concerned, yeah, there's a lot of confidence in the dressing room. Like they say, one swallow doesn't make a summer. So we are still confident, and we'll surely come back next game with a good, solid game plan. One, look at the state of the game and see which player can be the best at that particular situation. And two, to give our other batsmen, apart from obviously MS, a chance to go there and take the responsibility and take the game till the end. So we want more finishers. We want to train and groom more finishers. And at the same time, we also want our 5, 6, 7 to be able to go in and learn the situation and play according to it, to adapt to it. So that is why you see the rotation, which augurs well. But very soon, I think we'll be settling into a fixed 5, 6, 7 as we get closer to the big day. More or less, you see most of the players pick themselves. We see how they do. So it's just a matter of one or two slots which we need to zero in and nail in. So which I think depends on the form at that particular point of time. Yeah.